Final Fantasy 13 2 with Game on Turtle.
Hey guys, this is Game on Turtle, and welcome back to Final Fantasy 13. Last time we were just about to check what that carbuncle thingy is. Okay, it's not in here. Just gotta find out what it is. Carbuncle, 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 carbuncle. Carbuncle, where are you? Where are you? Cannot view any information on it. So it is some kind of adornment, whatever that is. I gotta really figure out what those are. I mean, I haven't seen anything in this game where you can, customize your weapons and gear yet. I never really did that in Final Fantasy 13, and I still beat the game. I mean, I've seen a lot of people do it, and they do a lot more damage and such. I wonder if it's non-existent in this game, or just not introduced yet. Because we're still pretty close. We're not too far into the game yet.
The creatures that appear due to the paradox are so... whatever the case, it's...
it is all conjecture. What's that red thing? What the heck is that?
There's no way I could live in a place like that.
Okay, so we have... what is that red thing?
I just got a call from the director. You guys get a free pass, but remember to be careful.
Roger, roger. That is a pretty big jump. Let's go find out what's down here. I mean, we're supposed to go down here anyway. Yeah, jump. Uh-oh, here's the time gate. Here's our other time gate. Ah! Okay, so once we can kill those behemoths, then we should come back here. And then travel the rest of the area.
This must be the gate Hope was talking about.
Maybe. Yeah? What?
There's something on your mind.
Yeah, well, sure, but it's just personal stuff.
I'm assuming bothered by the Moogle. I want to ask, is it about the Oracle Drive?
Is it the Oracle Drive?
I guess you could say that, kind of, but not exactly.
In that prophecy, it really was lightning, wasn't it?
Well, we can't be sure of that.
You were there, man.
Okay, let's solve this paradox and find out. Sound good?
So are we gonna solve the paradox in this time, or... alright.
Something had been bothering Noel. And it had been ever since we heard the story about the Padre Cirrus Yule. But, of course, he wasn't the only one who was troubled. Was it really lightning I saw in the flickering images of the prophecy? The only way to find out is to go through this portal and solve the paradox.
Okay. Oh, we got a potion for that? So I guess wrong. Alright. New location. Oerba. Ooh, Oerba. 200 AF though. What is this? So which way do you guys want to go? I know you guys can't choose right now because you're watching me. What? You can close the gate? Whatever that means. Okay, we're gonna go this way since we're doing part of the story anyway, and then might as well find out.
A land that bears the scars of ancient war, where flakes of crystal gather and shift like sand in the desert. The Academy has restricted access to this place because it is the homeland of the two heroines who turned to crystal and held cocoons safe in the sky. it is a land that now, 200 years later, has been swallowed into a rift.
Okay, this place is definitely going to be messed up. It's going to be some kind of, like, time, space, mélange thing. And hopefully we can figure out how to fix that paradox, or destroy the paradox, or remove the paradox. The paradox effect. The weird thing is, Well, actually, I guess I can't comment on it yet, since I'm still in the beginning of the game. Ho ho! Beach. And floating stuff.
What's happening? The world is falling apart.
Is this a future where everything has been destroyed? Or is it a distant past before the world has even come into being?
Space-time has doubled and twisted on itself. The past and future are tangled together as one, Couple. Paradox is affecting space-time itself.
Right. And we have to find out what's causing this. Okay.
Whoever it was created the paradoxes. Really
question, what is behind us? Just the gate.
In a world abandoned
nothing
by the
else.
Sea,
wow.
Left behind,
it's supposed to be a beach with a bridge on it. But instead it's a bridge of time.
It's just an old fairy tale.
Jump! Should I do this? What are we supposed to do here? Talk to Koopo? Or just use the Koopo thing?
Come on,
yeah. Hey! Is that a time gate, or...? Oh, shoot. We've got absorbed by whatever that was. Prepare to be scared by the black screen of death.
It's like a maze. A crossroads within the
puzzle time.
Itself.
Puzzle, time, puzzle, puzzle time.
Intersect. I bet if we solve all these puzzles, we could dissolve the current paradox.
I bet that too, man. I bet it too. I mean, we can't do anything. We have to solve the puzzle to actually get out of here. It would be fun if Noel actually helps you. The shape and color of crystals will continually change. Simply move to a crystal of the same shape and color to connect them. Oh. What? Okay, this is gonna be confusing. Okay. Oh my god. My brain is farting so bad. There's two reds and two blacks, but then the rest of them are different color. How do you connect these? Oh, you just hold it down. Okay. Not too bad. This is fairly simple, I mean. Just hold down X. Change. 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 Okay, don't change. Oh, you just changed. Change. Oh, come on. Aw, man. It changed while I was doing it, man. So you guys get, I could just walk everywhere. What is that, a Koopo? Or like some kind of... I just want to be sure that I'm not messing this up. Change, 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 change. Do I have to move around for you to change? Do I have to let go? It doesn't... like really... connect really quickly. And one last one.
Whoo!
It's kind of awkward control. I prefer the other puzzle better. Because, like, as you're running through it, if I hold down X, as soon as I hit the tile, it doesn't register as fluidly. I mean, it should really just be me holding down X the whole time, and then it just drags the connection bond or whatever. And we exit that area and fix some of the paradox effect stuff. We got a treasure over there. We got a couple billboards. And Noel just jumped backwards. No. Screw. Okay, let's fight that. It's a hand. The seeker hand. Alright. Let's really get some AoE going on here. Manually choose our AoEs. Wait, how do you... Ah, crap. I thought... Oh, yeah. Just doing AoE. I mean, the Faraga, like, stuns them too, so... Frog is probably the wrong spell to use on these guys, actually. Still work fine. And we got 5 stars. Let's see what we've got. Seth tier. Okay, where's that treasure? Give me that treasure. What you got in there? 2 Geisel Greens. Thank you. Can we jump this way? What is this? Nothing. Let's jump down here. Koopo's down here. Whoa! Seath? Or Seep? Or Gas? Alright, we're just gonna... maybe buff ourselves. Why is he doing so much damage? Meow, 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 meow. That's enough buffing. He's a protected guy, I think. And let's kill this ghast ass. Ghast ass. Oh, we got a bunch of these little guys. We should probably kill those first. Uh-oh. Use pot. Pot. And let's switch. Let's take out these guys with a healer, so make it easier for us. We have to kill the Seekers first, since they're being a little pain in the asses. Constantly hitting us. Hurting our little Koopo. I wish we could use our Koopo to fight. That would be so cool. So much cooler than... Hey, you want some of this Seeker? Huh? From Harry Potter? Huh? Harry? Harry Potter? Harry? Okay, now we're gonna kill this guy. Which should be easy enough. I mean, he's already, like, dead. And... boom, boom. It would be nice if that actually did more damage. It feels like it does nothing. And the ghast should be dead. In about another hit. There. Dead. Dead. That was 3 out of 5 stars, not 2.